Good morning, everybody. This is Brother Lloyd. And to those who are keeping the Sabbath today, Shabbat Shalom. I will be having a peaceful and a blessed Sabbath day. Now, today we're going to talk about something that steers, guides, and drives too many people's lives, and that is fear. Too many of you, especially those of you who claim to be believers, are living your life in fear and letting that dictate the course of your life, when the simple answer to that question is follow the Father's word. Put your faith and your trust in the Father, but you're not doing it, but yet you claim to be a believer. So we're going to talk about fear, we're going to break it down, and we're going to use the word to do that, and I'm going to give you a couple of examples of some things you are doing which lead to condemnation if we're not careful. We have to be careful and not live our lives according to fear, because we'll give right into what the enemy wants us to do. So with that, let's get started.
Soon I will be done with the troubles of this world. Oh, my troubles of this world, troubles of this world.
Now, like I said, many of you have some issues going on in your lives that are destroying your marriages in chaos, your family is out of control, your kids, they're doing whatever, they're out of control, they're doing this, that, and the other, especially you all with teenage kids, disobedient, all that, and even some adult kids. And you also let this fear drive your job situations. You pander and cater to people that you know you shouldn't be working with, but yet every day you go in there, you bring that stress home, you go to work under stress, you come home under stress, different stresses, you're mixing them, you're confused, chaos, all that. But the first thing I'm going to talk about is not keeping your commitments and promises that you make to the Almighty up in heaven. And primarily we're going to talk about the Sabbath. Now, you Sabbath keepers, they know, for all you non-Sabbath keepers, Sabbath keepers know and understand that there are people that watch us and watch how we keep our obligations 100 times closer than anyone that keeps Sunday. Now, why is this? The reason is because we make claims that we are dedicated, devoted, and seriously committed to the Father's word. So plenty of people can't wait to see someone who claims to be so committed, especially when the Sabbath is involved, they can't wait to see us do something contrary to the word we claim to be keeping, so that they can throw us under the bus, justify their own actions in doing what they do, and bottom line, say we're no different than anyone else. And that's what's going on in the world. So we have to be very careful. Now, on top of all that, the coup de grace is, one, we know better, and we're going to be held accountable. Secondly, we unplant a seed that we initially planted. We're going to be held accountable. We know. Okay, secondly, let me say this, especially to those who are Sabbath breakers, not keeping the truth. There are plenty of people out there who firmly believe in their heart of hearts that Sunday is a true worship day, and they are sincere and loyal in keeping it faithfully. No job, no party, no family member, no friend, or whatever is going to stop them from keeping their obligation to what they firmly believe as the truth. So what makes you think that you being watched that much closer than anyone else is not going to be held accountable by the world and by the Father? They may be the very ones that are saved, and you end up lost, because you have a higher standard of knowledge by comparison. So I'm going to ask you this. What's your excuse when you know what's going to come? See, the sifting is going to weed out all the false believers, whether they're Sunday keepers or Sabbath keepers. So don't worry about all that. it's going to take care of itself. The Father's Word tells us that, and we know this. Now, for my son to keepers, I have a question. Google, watch the news, but you better pay attention. The world governments, led by the pontiff himself, are about to start changing laws, mandating that Sunday becomes the legal, recognized day of worship. It may start off here and there, but it's going to be everywhere. And with the Pope behind it, it's going to go worldwide before you can blink your eye once it gets seriously rolling, which it already is. But a lot of you aren't even paying attention. You're going on through your daily lives, doing whatever, and they'll pass this law at midnight like everything else, and you'll never know the difference because you'll be doing what you do. But Sabbath keepers will know because we know what's going to come. Now, understand this. They're going to do all this under guises of doing things like bringing families closer together for worship, worshiping of God or whatever, but it's going to be on Sunday under the guise of closing retail businesses and theaters and all these other forms of entertainment that aren't necessary. So when they make a law mandating that a particular day is a legal day of worship, then they can close all that other stuff, and it's going to be ghost towns everywhere. It's been that way before. Some of you aren't old enough, but plenty of you are and have lived in states like Virginia that have had quote-unquote blue laws before where everything's closed on Sunday. So anyway, they're going to go back to that, but this time it's going to be even more serious. So keep in mind that the enemy will always use man to push forth his objectives, because man is always readily available to be used by the enemy because of sin. We allow the enemy to use us to do his work. He can't do it on his own, so he uses us. And we willingly, through our sin, do it. But back to the question. If Sunday is the true worship day, and this is to you Sunday keepers, if Sunday is the true worship day, which, by the way, is not mentioned in Scripture whatsoever, even vaguely, but if it is, and most people are already doing it anyway, why would you have to make a law mandating it? Why do you need laws? Most people keep Sunday anyway. And those who don't primarily keep Saturday. And then you have those who just do whatever it is they do. But I'm going to tell you why. The reason why is because once you make it a law, those who aren't following the law are violating it. Now, you can do what? You can legally punish and persecute them under the penalties of that law. Sabbath keepers already know this, and we already know what's going to take place. We've been watching everything for years. We have seen this coming, and it's going to come into fruition, and we understand that it's about persecution. Regardless of what they disguise it as, we've all seen conspiracies before, and this conspiracy is going to be under the guise of so many things, but when it's said and done, we're going to see the persecution. Now, with this move, this is going to be one of the greatest perversions that the enemy has pulled off. But go with me to Daniel 7:25, and I'm going to show you how he's twisting Daniel 7:25. But the truth is still in it. Keep in mind, the truth is always in the Father's Word. Satan twists it, manipulates it to satisfy his needs. But I'm going to read it to you, and I'm going to show you what I'm talking about. Daniel 7:25. It reads, it says, "And he shall speak great words against the Most High, and he shall wear out the saints of the Most High, and think to change times and laws. And they shall be given into his hand until a time and times and the dividing of time." To make a long story short, focus on the one part. It says, "And think to change times and laws, times and laws, times and laws, times and laws." That's the truth right there. See, the enemy's doing that through changing laws by using man. And once he changes the Sunday law to make that a law, then all the rest of Daniel 7:25 can take place at even a grander scale. He will speak great words against the Most High. He will wear out the saints of the Most High, and they shall be given into his hand. See, all this stuff's going to come to pass where just believers in the Father's Word are going to be turned over to the world and all his judges and juries and persecution whatsoever. Family members are going to turn against family members for favor and gain and all that. been there. We've talked about this before. Now, part of the reason I went to the Sunday and Sabbath keeping thing is to illustrate and express that this is one of the biggest fears of Sabbath keepers when it comes to keeping the Father's word. And what I mean by that is they violate the Sabbath, just like Sunday keepers constantly violate Sunday, but no one thinks anything of it. But Sabbath keepers know better and are held to a higher level of commitment, but they violate keeping the Sabbath for things like what? Primarily jobs. See, that's the biggest Achilles heel for Sabbath keepers. Jobs, because they require you, 90 some odd percent of them at some point or another, require you to work during the Sabbath. And Sabbath keepers will struggle with this, and so many are violating keeping the word because of fear. They are fearing losing a job. Now, what's this saying? This is saying that you're not trusting in the Father. You don't have faith in His word. You don't believe His promises. See, now let's look at Sunday keepers for a minute. You have Sunday keepers that, like I said before, they firmly believe in Sunday, and nothing is going to stop a lot of them from keeping their obligation on Sunday. Even though it's, for most, it's just in part for a few hours here and there. Nothing is going to stop them. Not a job, not a barbecue, not a friend, not shopping, not cookouts, whatever. They are going to keep their obligation to their faith commitment on Sunday. Even Sabbath keepers who do things that are in the area of helping people, because Sabbath keepers understand that it is good to do good on the Sabbath. So they twist their own thinking and thinking, well, I'm in a job where I help people, police, firemen, doctors, whatever. And they use that to think that they can manipulate the Father's word to violate the Sabbath and claim they're keeping it because they're doing good on the Sabbath. Because that's what Christ did. He helped on the Sabbath. He illustrated to us that it is good to do good, especially when it comes to life and death on the Sabbath. And just as there are Sabbath keepers who break the Sabbath, there are Sunday keepers who don't keep their faith commitment on Sunday. But see, part of the difference is so many of them, if they miss it because of work or something that they have to do, they go, well, whatever, there's next Sunday, and they think nothing of it. Why? Because their level of understanding and commitment and knowledge on this particular subject is vastly different than most of ours who keep the Sabbath. We keep the Sabbath in the first place and adhere to it because we know what a serious commitment is. We don't waver in that understanding. So when we go to violate that commitment, it brings such grief and pain and conviction that it can drive you into a frenzy. We know the word, and we understand that that commitment of the fourth commandment, Exodus 20, verses 8 through 11, is a serious thing. So keep this in mind, especially you Sabbath keepers out there who break the Sabbath for things like work, because that's really the only excuse for most of them. James 4:17 reads like this. It says, therefore, to him that knoweth to do good and do it not, to him it is sin. But don't fear. I'm not finished breaking it down using the word yet. This is Brother Lloyd. I'll be back. Thank you.